Hello parents, how are you all? Good morning for US and good evening for Indians. Okay, so I am sure you all are enjoying your quarantine period, lockdown, and I am sure we all must have ventured lots of new options right now. And whatever it is, however it is, how much ever we grip for it, but one thing is beautiful about this lockdown, and I feel really fortunate and blessed that it has come in the era where we are blessed with best of the technology. This machine out here is helping me to get connected to you all so smoothly. So basically, you know, through this lockdown, we have realized that world has become very small. Like for any teacher like me, now there is no boundary. Anybody can be my student because I can offer everything online now. So that way, this lockdown has done wonderful food for us and for this lovely kids, because one thing we have realized is that we were losing and wasting lots of time in traveling. And because of that, our productivity was going down. So that thing is a blessing in disguise, that now these kids don't have to travel anywhere. Though they, you know, you at your home and I at my place, and still we are connected with each other. I will not brief you all about my profile and my career, I mean my education and my pattern of teaching and all. Pattern of teaching, yes, I'll be covering it up over here, but what is my background and you know, those all things I won't cover up out here, because it's already there in the message which has been attached to this video. Over here I will like to talk with y'all about one very important thing, that why math is important to be introduced to kids in an early age. You know, right now I am talking to y'all, and there are many parents who are listening to me. If you analyze, you know, 60 to 70% of the parents must be somewhere in their life must be having that fear of numbers. And that fear of numbers is so huge that right now also it's a phobia for them. So when we think that why there is this fear of numbers, and when we take a protocol of it, we realize that those numbers were not being exposed to us in a rightful way. But there are 30% of us, 30% of the parents who doesn't have any fear for numbers. And then they think and go to their past, then they will realize that those numbers were being introduced, were being part of their life from a very raw, you know, very young age. And they were being exposed to them in a rightful manner. Okay, so basically, numbers are very much important in our life. Like I always tell my parents that numbers are being needed everywhere. The cooking what you do needs calculation. Driving what we do needs calculation. Grocery what we go buy has math in it. So everywhere math is included, and math is the most integral part of our life. Whether we go for science or we go for art or we go for, you know, any field, legal field or designing field, anywhere to enter the field, entrance exam has got math. So there is no way out to ignore math. Now, importance of exposing math to kid in a young age is that you know, they become quite systematic in their thinking. They become quite systematic in their approach. They learn to manage their time in a quite efficient manner from young age. Such kids never tend to miss anything in school. They become quite sharp and observant. Their memory retention power goes very high. They learn to coordinate their brain, their hand, and their visual sights, you know. So basically, in you know, exposing math from a right age, from a young age, is very much crucial for any kid. Now, why child should come to me? I am completely into mental math. So basically, in mental math, kids will learn lots of tricks to solve their math in a quick manner. Okay, so basically, if I give you example, I cater to presently I cater to kids from grade 1 to grade 8. So if I give you example, if I give you an example of grade 1 kid will be trained in such a manner that in 1 hour's time the child will be solving 300 questions. Okay, and those 300 questions will be the mixture of addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, numbers, not division for grade 1, addition, subtraction, multiplication, numbers. These numbers are just not numbers, like they will be learning ascending numbers, descending numbers, missing numbers, combination of addition, subtraction, reading a clock. Then tables also they will be learning in a form of wheel. So basically there will be a mixture of activities in the worksheets, and those worksheets will be having 300 questions. So that paper will have 300 questions and child has to finish those 300 questions in 1 hour. And I will be training the child in such a manner that, you know, initially child will have a habit of using their fingers for counting. But gradually when they go from grade 1 to grade 2, they will stop using their fingers. So there are ways, like for tables from 2 to 9, they have to learn, you know, with a disciplined manner, with the right approach, they will be learning those 2 to 9 tables. But post that, 2 to 9 table, every child has to by heart. But post that, there are ways to do tables also. Then nobody has to remember tables because there are different ways to do tables. So, you know, basically in my class, I will be training kid to apply shortcuts, and certain places long cuts are also needed. So child will be learning the process of reading graphs. Grade 1 child will be learning the process of reading graphs. Grade 1 child will be learning the process of, bars. Basically, I don't know right now. This is, to be very frank enough, this is my cousins who are in Boston, Tralsawalas, Ashish and Sneha Tralsawala. They have recommended me this platform. And then I thought that, yes, why not? I mean, if I take class online in India, then why can't I take classes online in USA also? So that's why I have, curriculum wise, my curriculum is completely planned from grade 1 to grade 8. I am all set and all ready. But how this platform goes forward, I am quite new to it. I am quite fresh to it. So I cannot say from right now that, you know, but one thing is very clear that in my class, minimum there can be one child also, okay? Because I am new to this platform. Because if I get one student also, I want to get into it. But maximum, I won't go beyond 6. So as it's a Zoom class, every child can conduct a class from their place. And maximum, there will be 6 students in the class. Okay. Now, how the class goes? There will be certain worksheets. Daily, you know, every week worksheet, every week's worksheets will be WhatsApp to see. Once my class is formed, there will be a WhatsApp group. So on that WhatsApp group, your classwork worksheets and your homework worksheets will be WhatsApp by me in the PDF format, and you all need to take the printouts of those worksheets. So when my class is there, at that time child has to sit with those worksheets in a stapled format and one full scape book, and on the basis of those worksheets I will be taking the class forward. So the worksheets, what I will be doing in the class, in that context only homework will be assigned to the child. Now in this homework, whatever homework has been assigned earlier, younger kids, I am talking about younger kids right now, they will try to take help of parents. You know, elder kids will be fine-tuned by me from starting itself that they don't have to take help of parents. But grade 1 kids, maybe for 3-4 turns, you know, they might take help of parents. But you have to not encourage them to take the help. Because whatever homework will be assigned, those whole things must have been done in the class. Then only that will come as a homework. So you don't have to help them in their homework. Now, how y'all have to check their work? Checking homework is your responsibility. Answer keys will be shared by me. So on the basis of the answer keys, your work will become very simple to check their work, okay? Now, once you check their work, something goes wrong, put a cross and ensure that child redo that wrong question also on his or her own. You don't have to help them over there also, because from day one, they will be trained in that pattern, okay? Post that, post checking their work, before to, for example, if your class is on Wednesday, I expect that by Monday, you have to post second attempt, whatever goes wrong, tell them to redo those wrong questions. So that is called second attempt. Post second attempt, whatever goes wrong, on that particular sheet below, you have to mention a footnote that this sum has gone wrong. Or if all things have gone correct after second attempt or in first attempt, footnote, first attempt all correct, second attempt also all correct, you know. So I will get a glimpse that everything is correct. I will get a glimpse that there is a doubt over here and I have to cater to that doubt. So all these images, you have to email me 2 days prior to your class. So if it's on, your class is on Wednesday, then by Monday you have to email me the images of this worksheets, okay? So parents, I really feel that this is the very robust process what I have in my mind. And right now when during this time when we cannot allow kids to step out of the house, we need to, you know, involve them in the most productive manner. And how that is possible? That is possible through such kind of a pattern, through such kind of a process where they will be very much exposed to the process, and that will make them involved in this entire curriculum. So my game plan is to take once in a week 2 hours class for younger kids, as they will be like, for grade one kids, grade one, grade two kids, it will be once in a week initially for two batches, two turns, it will be 1 hour, then gradually this will increase and it will go on to 2 hours, okay? So as they are too small to sit at a stretch for 2 hours, and at that time I do not expect parent to sit next to them, because it's a proper classroom. Though it's virtual, but it's like a classroom where only teacher and child should be there with each other. So basically I feel this is the right process, right time, where the kids don't have anything to do, to get into this process. And then we can take things forward the way it goes, you know. So till then, and yes, my timings will be Indian time 8 to 10 p.m. 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. Indian time. So I think, so I'm assuming that that will be morning 10:30 to 12:30 in USA. So my Indian time will be 8 to 10 p.m. We will work out the days. And what if you have got any further queries, feel free to be in touch with me. The attached message has got my number. If you all want to have a proper meeting on Zoom, we can conduct that also, so that whatever queries you all have or whatever further understanding you all need about my curriculum, we can cover up over there. So till then, parents, bye. Stay safe, stay home, and enjoy your quarantine to the best manner. Thank you. Namaste.